opened up a new decade of hits and hitmakers, and although many attempted to make an impact, only a few left their mark. 20 years on, the classic band, our next guest fronts, are back and performing a massive gig to say thanks to the fans who loved them then and who certainly love them now.
Where does it go from here? Is it down to the lake?
Looked just like you because I was obsessed for you.
Wow, so you went for the...
I didn't know you were here!
And that, anyway. I remember, Nick, back in the day, you seemed to be in every hairdressing salon because loads of hairdressers put pictures of you from, I don't know if it was Smash Hits or whatever, and all the boys would go in and try and get their hair cut like you. Were you aware of that?
Kind of, but it's weird because I've never saw a shop called Haircut 100, and then there was one in Walthamstow, I think.
Okay. Where did you get the name from?
Out of the subconscious, literally, we used to have a name a week, and that was the name that week. You know, I think we used to sit around a coffee table and just come up with stuff. Uh-huh. And I said, Haircut 100, and then Les said, what did you say? And I said, I don't know, what did I say? You said Haircut 100. And we laughed, took it to our friends, they just said, you cannot have that name.
Yeah.
That is a ridiculous name. You won't get anywhere with that.
Colleen was like that with the Nolans, yeah. So it'll never catch on.
I tried to change it, but
they
wouldn't
have it.
You were so young, though, weren't you? Because weren't you 20 when you wrote Fantastic Day?
Yeah, well, actually, when it popped out, when its birth came out, it was earlier than that. It was 15.
Really?
15?
Yeah.
And is it true it was something to do with a girlfriend at the time thought wasn't necessarily encouraging in terms of your career, and you thought, right, I'll show you?
That was... well, actually, I kind of wrote it with Laura, mm-hmm. on my bed at that time. Yeah, I mean, I think she was kind of around when the second verse was made. Uh-huh. So then that song became kind of something when, right. later on, because we were all became single at the same time. That's where we focused on the band,
right.
to get it together.
Do you think you probably became single because every time you got in bed, you wrote songs?
Yes.
You look lovely tonight, love. I'll just write that down.
You've got two children, haven't you?
Yes.
So you managed to stop writing notes for at least twice.
Yeah, for 3 minutes.
Yeah. Well, were you at the birth?
Yes, both times. And
how lovely. Would you like to have a baby?
Would I?
I mean, I'm not propositioning.
I'd like to know how it would happen, because if it's being impregnated
I'll
by a woman...
I'll show you later if you'd like.
Yeah, maybe we can... Can you get me pregnant? Pregnant now.
Yes.
So what's your thought process? You said you can't understand how it would work. What do you mean?
Just the process.
Just the whole where would it be and where would it come out of?
Yeah.
Not go there, it's lunchtime. And Haircut 100, at that time when it was like massive with the Duran Duran Duran, why did you stand out so much? You know, like, I mean, I remember you more
just
actually.
Stop me there. Duran Duran
Duran. That's why I remember Haircut 100 more than I remember Duran Duran Duran.
Brilliant, absolutely brilliant.
What was it about you that was everybody just went for you?
I don't know. I think it could have been that we were young and wanted to be mothered a bit like that. Because we were, I mean, look at those pictures.
Oh,
yeah.
Fantastic.
Bless that.
And you're going to be going, you're performing at, is it the London Indigo 2 on Friday? Yeah. Is it going to be the original lineup?
It's actually the original lineup that, you know, around the coffee table. Mm. And so that's it. Yeah, but two are missing, like a smile that's just slightly, over the years, it's couple of teeth missing.
Yeah. Are you still mates? Because you do hear of, I mean, a lot of, there's a massive 80s revival on at the moment, and obviously you hear some bands have fallen out and reformed or what have you. Have you stayed friends? Have you stayed in touch?
That's just staying up straight, isn't it?
Anyone
yeah,
do something?
Yeah, yeah.
You tend to do that, yes.
Right. Yeah, it's after a while, it's a bit like, yeah, I'm in a pub or something. And we're just
saying,
yeah.
So are you mates?
Yes, well, we were mates then. That mm-hmm. was originally why we were mates before we started a band. Mm-hmm. So we were just friends, and we started a band because we had time. Mm-hmm. And there we were this summer, actually, in Cookham. And it was a lovely sunny day, and we're sitting in the garden, and we're just about to go off to do this concert. And we just realised that we really get on. And mm-hmm. we're friends first. You know, it's like the last of the summer wine now. You know, it has that feel, and that's really warm and you know, comforting.
Yeah. Is it really a one-off concert on Sunday, or are you going to tour?
Well, we haven't got any plans, really. That's naturally happening. And when we got together on Facebook, that's how originally, because we can get together before, but we can't keep it together. So this time, because of Facebook, we can keep it together, because that's a great thing about it. You can see everybody's families. Yeah. And,
very nice. And your children involved in your gig in any way?
Yes, Oliver. He does the sound.
Does he? Yeah,
does he?
Kate does makeup.
Oh, it's a family affair.
Yeah, it is.
Love and Olin.
You know, the fact, I mean, you're going to be on stage, you'll be performing, you know, all the lovely hits that we just heard there. There'll be a certain fan base there, like, I guess, our sort of age of women who remember you in the 80s. And then your kids are there backstage. Yeah. What does that feel like?
It'll be the same for the audience. It's reuniting for everyone, you know, and so therefore it'll just feel...
They'll be
glad
kids,
to be there.
They?
Yeah, that's what it'll be. And then maybe their kids are bringing their kids.
Yeah.
That's the lovely thing.
And you're going to be doing Pelican West.
Yes.
So, is it true that was one of the first ever digital albums that was recorded?
Yeah, it was really clear at the time. We thought it was a bit clear and a bit tinny, and and then it became our calling card, that kind of clear, crisp sound. You know, that clarity that I look back now, I mean, I'm rehearsing it and learning it, and there's bits in there that I didn't hear before.
Okay.
And that's what digital does. You know, you can hear it all at once, unlike analog, where bits are hidden.
Okay.
Some people like that. I mean, I love that warm 70s Carpenter sound. You know,
yes.
Spread. Yeah.
But you're lovely. I think it's going to be a lovely... I think we all need to go and see him in concert. You just know it's going to be lovely and friendly.
Yeah, you're coming. Anyway, back to birth. I'm still getting over my birth. Honestly,
your
I didn't
birth
breathe.
Or yeah, your children's birth?
Well, they were quite traumatic. I mean, just seeing them, you know, when you watch it, it's a bit like you return to your birth, almost.
Okay.
But somehow, subconsciously, you're returning there, because, you know, you used to get whacked in the 60s.
Yeah.
There was none of that now. And I think that may have been... So, I mean, imagine coming into this world and getting whacked on the...
It's kind of
where
like,
am I? You know?
It's very similar to coming on
this
show.
Place?
You appear there, you come on the desk, whack, then you're off again. Talk of haircuts, we need time to check our own after the break. Is it tacky to stamp your mark on a home? We'll see you in a bit.